Lee County beaches have been spared from red tide for weeks, but the latest report shows the bloom is back. Experts say it is trickling down from the north, with background to medium concentrations already showing up in Lee. NBC2's Nestor Montoya is live near the Sanibel Causeway after talking to businesses still working to bounce back.
Well, past this causeway, businesses got big relief, but that soon might end. New numbers of red tide are showing a 5 to 25% increase in Lee County since Wednesday, with Sanibel's Lighthouse Beach as one of the affected shores where this algae is showing up. A picture-perfect scene.
We love Sanibel.
Beaches once ravaged by red tide, now clear, with visitors returning, some even escaping it from Florida's east coast.
But with the red tide, we were concerned, and then once we heard it was all clear, we headed over. I'm going to enjoy this weekend.
But a new report suggests good beach weekends could soon end as red tide creeps back down to Lee County.
It was devastating.
Doug Babcock of Sanibel Captiva Beach Resort says the algae crippled business for months throughout the island, including several of their properties.
Business levels were off about 40 to 50% kind of July through August.
A four-week break from the bloom helped.
We're seeing good improvement in the business levels, but still certainly not out of the woods.
Experts say high concentrations in counties to the north could soon trickle down, but Babcock says he's not overly concerned about it.
There is a little bit of a hot spot up in the Sarasota area, and depending on wind direction, that certainly could hit our area again, but it will be a setback. It'll be a disappointment, and it certainly will hurt business going forward.
Now, the levels at Lighthouse Beach are listed as very low, so if you want to enjoy the beach week this weekend, you better enjoy it soon rather than later. I'm live in Lee County tonight. Nestor Montoya, NBC2.